It took about 20 years before science owned what I was talking about. If you understand epigenetics, you don't need the pharmaceutical industry. That's not in the interest of the, you know, one of the biggest industries on this planet to say you can heal yourself without drugs. And I go, absolutely. Look, I can feed you with an idea that this pill that we just got from the pharmaceutical company, it's the greatest, best thing for your issue. And I give you this pill and you get better. And then later you find out it was a sugar pill and everybody goes, yeah, that's called the placebo effect. And I go, what does it really mean? I said, you didn't get healed by the pill, you got healed by the belief in the pill. At least one third, minimum of one third of all medical intervention is, it's the placebo effect that where the healing comes from. Everybody goes, yeah, I know about the placebo. I go, yeah, but that's a result of positive thinking. What about negative thinking? And this is what we don't talk about, but the reality is it's equally powerful in regard to affecting your biology as is positive thinking, but it works in the opposite direction. A negative thought is called the nocebo effect. Can cause any disease and you can die. If you believe you're gonna die, you can die from the belief. So we really have to watch out because, as psychologists would tell us, 70% or more of our thoughts are negative and redundant, replaying the same negative thoughts. I go, if thoughts had nothing to do with it, fine. But thoughts, positive or negative, shape our biology. And all of a sudden it says, well, now it's time to wake up because our negative thinking is manifesting a negative life experience. It took about 20 years before science owned what I was talking about and gave it the name epigenetics. That's the new science.
Okay, which is the belief that through your behavior, you can kind of alter your genetics, pass those on, express it differently. I'm probably using the wrong words.
Well, pretty close right now.
Now people talk about it as a reality, although it's still not totally understood or totally believed.
But it can be replicated. It is now. It is a science. It's a hard science, and it's the leading edge. Now, I'll tell you where the problem comes from. Not so much the scientists, but the pharmaceutical industry. And the reason why this becomes important is because the pharmaceutical industry runs the show in medicine. And if you could put this kind of healing that I'm talking about into a capsule or tablet, they'd be talking about it right now. But this is a consciousness healing, and you can't sell it. And so what's the result? They're not interested in it. And they, through their money, which is massive, actually determine the curriculum in a medical school. And one of the things they're trying to get rid of are people who respond to the placebo effect, because the placebo effect throws the data right off the chart. A simple fact is this, and people might be upset, but the drugs like Prozac in laboratory tests are no better than a sugar pill. And that's how many billions of dollars a day on this planet are spent buying Prozac.
Yes.
Or statin drugs. Statin drugs help less than 3% of the people that take them. And in fact, they cause side effects that are dangerous in about 23%. So you help 3% with a drug, 23% are getting toxic from the drug. And the idea is these are drugs that, how long do you take statins? How long do you plan to live?
Yeah.
It's like, oh my God, that's a, you know, they're drug
they're
dealers. Look, it's advertised every 10 minutes on television. There's a new drug or a drug, and it's put into their heads like, your life's not working right. This drug, look at the happy people. See, they've taken the drug and how happy they are. And people buy that story, and pharmaceutical drugs kill about 300,000 people a year. And everybody's, oh, that's just the cost of doing medicine. And yet they have a war on drugs, which kill less than 30,000 people a year. And all of a sudden you got a war because 30,000 people died. 300,000 people die. That's business as usual.
Okay. How do we break this cycle? How do you fight these huge companies?
Basically stop buying the product. And you say, but how can I stop buying the product? And the answer is, well, empower yourself because you're the one that controls all this. Any drug that affects you, you got to understand this. If I take a drug and it affects me, the reason why it affects me is because I have a natural equivalent of that drug in my own biology. You don't take a drug and it affects you and you have a receptor for that drug, like you are having this protein receptor for a drug you may never take. That would be silly. So if you have a receptor for a drug, then by definition, that receptor was already there because there was a natural drug. So in smoking pot, everyone, oh, no, there's a drug called tetrahydrocannabinol. And guess what? You have receptors for it because you make your own. So the idea is this, well, if you want to have the effect of the drug, do you have to take an outside drug? I say, no, you have to change your consciousness because you already manufacture every equivalent of a drug right now. And the idea is, if you're not manufacturing it, then it means your consciousness is not supporting you in your health. And it's really an adjustment of consciousness, not an adjustment of your biology.